where you live. and Dan Quayle, because I feel that they're the most trustworthy and definitely the only ones capable of running this country.
For Clinton, because I don't like Bush, and Perot dropped out, so I think he's very good.
Perot, because I think that he knows how to manage the money good and stuff for our economy.
Clinton, because he has the best economic plan.
Clinton, because he knows what he's doing. Clinton, because his vice president can spell.
Well, I don't like Bush, and I don't like Perot. I think he's a goofball. And I think Clinton and Gore can get the job done.
I didn't vote.
Why did you vote for Ross Perot?
Funny looking.
I voted for Ross Perot. He's the only one that really addresses the issue.
Donald Duck.
Why did you vote for Donald Duck?
He's a cartoon.
Bush, because Clinton lies and Perot, I don't know, he's just kidding around.
I voted for Bill Clinton because he's a cool guy.
Let me ask my shame. some questions about the blizzard of the 93. What did you do during the storm?
Stayed inside at my friend's house and watched movies or something.
What did you do during the storm?
Slept.
Well, we made snowmen and we played in the snow, snow fights, stuff like that.
This was a real emergency that we all needed to work together and get through the best we could.
Sending our troops over to Somalia.
I think they should send them over because there's people dying over there because they can't get their food.
Definitely, yeah. There's people can't help themselves, and we definitely need Americans to help them.
I think we should be minding our own business.
I think it's pretty stupid because we don't need all them people over there to just fight for somebody else.
We should because they really need the food, and we need to help them out as much as we can.
I think now is a good idea to send food over there and get rid of the problem over there.
We should help them because, you know, they're starving and they need support from the United States and the United Nations.
It's not a war that where our boys are going to fight in or anything like that. We're over there to see that the starving people get needed food, and I think it's very worthwhile.
What's your opinion on the Rodney King verdict?
Well, I think it's fair because the two officers that were rookies just went along with their commanding officers who got sentenced, and they were just doing what they were told to do, so I think it's fair.
I think that they all should have been guilty because they were all following the orders of their command, and that he said do it, they all did it, and so they should all be guilty because they all did it.
What do you think of the situation in Waco, Texas?
Well, I feel sorry for the kids. I wish that never happened because kids don't deserve it. They didn't have a choice. But as far as David Koresh, he got everything he deserved.
I thought it was a setup. I thought that they didn't burn down. I think that the government burned down. Because why would they want to burn their own compound down? To keep themselves safe.
Just the end of time.
Excited.
It's exciting and I can't wait to get out of here.
It's just great and I can't wait to start a career.
It's sad. I don't want to graduate.
I'm just surprised I made it, man, but while I'm here along for the ride, it's a pretty cool thing.
It feels great.
Yeah. Pretty good. It feels real good to be graduating. Can't wait to get out of here.
I'll miss my friends, but it feels really good.
Graduated. How are you feeling right now?
Going to Disney World.
I feel relieved I got a C in Ziegler's class. That's all I really worried about.
Give us a call, 1-800-426.
I believe it would be disruptive, so therefore I will not become a candidate. The volunteers in all 50 states have asked me to run as a candidate for President of the United States.
There is no mediation. There are no peace talks. Only Serbs and Muslims battling it out.
The National Weather Service is calling it a 100-year storm because storms of this severity only come round about once a century.
California prepared to send out IOUs.
General Motors officials shocked nearly everyone.
1992 is not a year on which I shall look back with undiluted pleasure.
The American people have voted to make a new beginning.
Only the United States has the global reach
to place a large security force on the ground in such a distant place quickly and efficiently.
There's been an explosion deep below the 110-story towers of the World Trade Center in New York City.
The fate of those inside the Dravidian cult compound is unknown.
As a global economy is taking shape.
And with the devastation that this thing has wrought, I really probably think it is the storm of the century.
The Toronto Blue Jays down the Atlanta Braves. It's 10th round action billed as one of the greatest rounds in the history of the sport.
Loretta lets it go and it's intercepted by Tommy Johnson.
North Carolina is the national champion. Kelly's going to throw. Here's Haley. Hit him and picked off in the air. Jimmy Jones intercepts.
The truth, you can't handle the truth.
I saw a man with no clothes, no money, no plate, Mr. White. That's his name.
It's all right. We're closed.